we all are teachers. That is the basic role of a, like the teachers, the basic role is what? They are teaching. What, that is the regular activity of the teacher. Okay, so in fact, today is a very memorable day in the history of St. Martin Engineering College, because always I feel, okay, so Teacher's Day should be celebrated in a very grand way, and I would like to appreciate my management and their magnanimity the day and the moment I proposed for the celebration of Teacher's Day, and it is not a yes, it is a big yes. So can we have a big round of applause? So hopefully you are happy in two ways. One is what, you are relaxed from class, so you have cancelled all of your classes. Okay. So not for MBA or NAC work or autonomous work. It is for spending some time with each other and to understand what we have done so far and what are all things we are yet to do. So, and the moment you have entered, I think you would have received your surprise gift also. All of you have received? Okay, who have all received, please raise your hand. Great, everybody has received. So here the attendance is 100%. Okay, so the real surprise will be when you will take it, open it, okay, and start pouring the hot water or a milk or a coffee or tea, whatever you like, then you will see the magic. It's a magic cup. Okay, so that we have thought, okay, to give you a small appreciation the moment you will come inside the room. And I could also able to see lot of gifts are kept in the form of color papers are wrapped, okay. Lot of gold coins are there, silver coins are there, okay. So just to felicitate the contribution what you have done for the profession what you have chosen. So advance congratulations who are all people are going to get it today. But this journey is not going to end today. For remaining people, it should be taken it as an inspiration, as an example, so that you should be the next person on stage to get it. So we are ready and we are happy to give it to everybody. But there are some parameters, right? Okay, so you have to come to the benchmark. So the magnanimity of the management is always there for you. And always I am there to talk about you for all the welfares. So we are there to felicitate you in all the occasions wherever it is possible. So again I would like to thank to all of you for trusting on us and continuing your professional journey with us, so that all the laurels and achievements which we will see together and parallelly all the facilities also can be given to you all. So when the Teachers Day started, as you know, 5th September, okay, every day we know, and it is like the morning itself, lot of messages will come and lot of calls will come, lot of emails will come, WhatsApp nowadays popular, okay, all these things will be coming. Okay, so please raise your hand. Okay, so if you have received any phone calls or messages, somebody to whom you have taught and he has recognized and called you, or at least he has sent a message, who are all people, please let us see that. Great, very great. Okay, so 90% of the crowd. Okay, now my next question, how many of you have called to your own teachers and taken blessings? Raise your hand. Good, good. Okay. Appreciable. Okay, now the next question will be, okay, so let us close our eye for 1 minute and remember all the teachers who had created or who has changed our personality and life, and because of their contribution, today we are at this level. So let us close our eyes for 1 minute. Okay, then I will give you a wake-up call. Okay, and recall all the teacher's face or the name, in case if you have remembered the names. Okay, now the time starts. No cheating. I will give you a wake-up call. Right, sir? Time over. So you were able to see some teachers' face and name? Okay, so different level of teachers we have come across, right? When we were small kids, we have come across about the school teachers, then high school teachers, then college teachers, then at the university, different professors. Okay, whose names and faces were coming to your mind? Are you able to get some names and face? Okay, so how many? How many of you could able to recall at least 5 faculty names or face? Raise your hand. Okay, almost all. 10? 15? Sir, prize is not there for this question. So you have to maintain honesty on that. Okay, so no prize is there for this question. Games we have kept after this formal event. Great. Okay, so thank you very much. So that at least you could able to recognize your teachers. Now the message to you all. Okay, so when I put the question, you can close your eyes and you start remembering your teachers. You could able to remember all teachers or few teachers? Few teachers, right? Okay. Now the message is, we all are in the teaching profession. And down the line, this question will be asked to somebody else in some other forum. Whether your face and your name will come in their mind when they will close their eyes. That question we have to ask ourselves. Whether my name and my face will come in others' mind when this question will be asked. If yes, you are justifying to your duties and you are really contributing in the great way how it is all expected. Everybody is expecting about the greatness and everybody want to become a successful. Yes or no? We tell our children also, study well, you will be successful. We tell to our younger brother and sister, wherever opportunity is there that we are senior and there is a scope to give advice, we stood up and took the leadership as of, no, there is a chance to take care of the front fellow. Okay, so we start giving the advices. And same way it is happening for whom we are the juniors and they feel that they are senior to us. Same thing is happening for us also. So everybody want to become successful. Either student or faculty. Yes or no? Yes. How many of you want to be successful in your career? Raise your hand if you want to be successful. Good. What madam, this is 50% successful? If I want to be successful, I have to raise my hands. Okay. So, everybody wanted to do that. Okay. So now the question is there any formula? Is there any formula or is there any procedure which we can be successful? There are many formulas are there, right? Or is there any formula anywhere it is written, you have read? There is no formula, sir. Okay, there is only one thing which was addressed by our former President of India, Dr. Abdul Kalam sir. And I had an opportunity to meet with him as you would have seen the photo also. Okay, so he was addressing and I was there in that program and he told one thing. If you want to be successful, you need to have the dare. You need to have the courage. You need to have the courage if you want to be successful. Okay, then the next question he asked, how the dare will come? How the courage will come? Then he said, courage will come from knowledge. And how the knowledge will come? Knowledge will come from two things. One is what? Creativity and righteousness. What is that? Creativity and righteousness. Creativity, everybody knows, it is all beyond thinking, out of box thinking, all this. What is righteousness? I will come to that point. Righteousness will come from two areas. One is what? Parents with a holistic atmosphere, they will provide the righteousness. Holistic atmosphere. Not like husband is beating to the wife. Or in return, same vice versa. Okay. Parents in a holistic atmosphere. And second one is what? Teachers. Teachers will give the righteousness. So the basic foundation which will lead to success and which will enhance the knowledge matrix, which will make you more successful. From where it comes? Parents with a holistic atmosphere and from the teachers. So we have the responsibility to producing all the successful people for the society. That responsibility we are shouldering on our head. So it's a big responsibility. So now the question needs to be asked to every individual. The profession what I have chosen, am I all or are, whether I am doing justifying to it, am I able to meet to the righteousness which is all required? That is the question. So if this question comes to your mind, undoubtedly, I need not have to mention, you will become a great teacher. You will become a great teacher. And again, the loop continues. The first question what I had asked, if in future the question will be asked to your student, by closing your eyes, you remember the faculty face, your memory. It will make a small difference. You see the any leaders, either in sports or in academic or in political, anywhere, any areas, without a mentor, they were not successful. So it is also equally important in the life, you need to have a right mentor for you. So for two students and as well as for faculty, right mentor will lead you to the success. So that is why there is a say, if you want to become a good teacher, you should be a good student too. We all are students, right? Every day we are learning. Anybody can raise and his hand and say that one, he's your hand and say that one, sir, I am enough. This subject I have studied. Any question you ask. It's not like that. Nobody can say that. Even I had an opportunity to interact with many IIT professors also. They say that what we know, it is just 2 to 5%. We have to learn. So that attitude is also should be there if you want to become a great teacher. So I will narrate you one small incident and you will see how the teachers and the perspective about the teachers, the students, they expect. Wonder what happened. One teacher went to inside the classroom. And whenever you enter inside the classroom, how the atmosphere of the student inside the classroom? They will be chit-chatting, talking, all these things will be happening, right? Right? And the moment you go inside, it will be a silent. So like that. So similarly, in a particular college, one teacher went inside a classroom, students are sitting. Okay, the moment the teacher went, one of the students stood and asked, sir, I have a question for you. Okay, then the teacher asked, okay, tell me what is the question. What is the great thing in the society? What is the great thing in the society? What is called great? Everybody talks about great thing, great thing. I wanted to know. In fact, we wanted to know what is the great thing in the society. As you are our teacher, please let us know. Then the teacher was so irritated and threw his notebook and all inside the classroom and he said that, you fellows are not at all interested for studies. You need the reason to disturb the class. That is why you got all these doubts. That is why I was not interested to come to your class and take the class. Correct? It happens, right? Okay, if I am a computer programming teacher and I have gone inside the class and if this question was asked, okay, then it will be irritating. Because I expect some question related to my subject. What is this question they were asking? So he was so irritated and he left the class and went out. I will not take. I will go and report to the HOD. I don't want this class henceforth. Immediately, when the teacher left the class and went outside, the students started talking. And what they started talking? They started talking ill about the faculty. What they started talking? Ill. They did not feel that when the question what they asked, it is not correct. They felt that teacher is not good. They started talking. And the faculty went to the staff room, sat for 5 minutes in the staff room. Something came to his mind. Okay, again he decided to come back to the classroom. After 5 minutes, again without reporting to anybody, again the faculty came inside the classroom and they entered into the same classroom picked the notebook and all, kept it on the table. And the moment the faculty entered, immediately he greeted the student. "Student, how are you all?" Then students were shocked and surprised. What has happened? Before 5 minutes, this is the thing. And the 5 minutes after that, the teacher is coming and greeting us. Then the teacher told, "Okay, so the question what you had asked, it is really a great question, and I could not able to control myself without appreciating you all. At this age, how you got this kind of critical question in your mind? I must appreciate to you all for that." Then everybody started clapping. Everybody started clapping. Everybody was so happy. Then the teacher told, "This is also the answer for your question." Then the students were confused. "Where is the answer? Where is the answer?" Then the teacher told, "Greatness is about the talk and about the speech what we address to the public and address to the students." See, before 5 minutes, when I came and I scolded you all, you all people were talking ill about me. I could able to notice that. And the moment I told your question is really great and I need to appreciate for the thought what you got, and you started appreciating me. So the great thing in the world, you wanted to know how you present and what you talk. So that is why the great thing is about the talk. So what we have to understand from this small story what I presented to you, always when we go to the student, we will have our own tensions. File work is not completed, HOD has told something, floor duties are assigned, lot of issues will be there. But that should not represent on our face when we go inside the classroom. And once we go inside the classroom, that 15 minutes, you are the owner of that 15 minutes. Nobody should disturb you and nobody should take the mental peace from you. You are, and students are there, and what is the knowledge you have, that has to be passed to the student. So what I request to you all, okay, everybody, every student wanted to see a smile on teacher's face. So let us cultivate that practice, inculcate those good practices to represent ourselves in a pleasing way to the student, so that we will be memorable in their mind and also we will be easily approachable. There are many things I can quote about the teachers, and the teachers, if they want, all wonders they can do. Just to conclude some of the examples, if you go to Japan or if you have read about Japan, okay, there all the ministers are there, and for these ministers who are all advisors, you know, teachers, college teachers and professors are the advisor to the ministers. So that level of respect was given to the teacher. Now, if I can recall what I had studied in my school days in a subject called history, you know a king, there was a king named as Dhananand. How many of you have heard the name, king name, Dhananand? History, SNH faculty at least. It was there in the history. Okay, now I will give you one more clue, you will be able to understand. How many of you have heard about the Chanakya? You know Chanakya, but you don't know Dhananand. Chanakya has taken the revenge on whom? Dhananand. Okay. Dhananand was a great king. Great king. He was having a very big kingdom and properties and all very high. And you know that the history continues, because if I will tell, it will take a long time. Okay, so one particular incident, Dhananand misbehaved to Chanakya. And what was the Chanakya? Chanakya was a teacher. He was a teacher. Guru. He was misbehaved. And he was so angry and he left the kingdom. Then again, you know that teachers, they can bring any changes. And again, he identified one potential candidate, and he started grooming him. What is his name? Chandragupta. And at the small age, he was grooming in such a way that he should come up with a great leader. And finally, what has happened? The story everybody knows. Dhananand was totally wiped out. And it was a revenge of a teacher. So teachers are more powerful. If they determine, if they committed, all impossible, they will make it as possible. How you did NAC A plus? Okay, so it is a commitment about the teachers, and I was so happy and delighted to express again and again, before me, you all started dreaming about NAC A plus. That is what the commitment of a teacher. Everybody will fail. If the commitment is done by the teachers, it will lead to all success. In life, there are many teachers who will come across. I can remember my school day teachers, college day teachers, and morning I have called them, I have missed them, greeted them, I have taken their blessings. And there are many teachers on the way of your life also will come. And I would like to mention you here in the open forum, the great teachers about the health and the sports, our Honorable Chairman M. Lakshman Reddy sir. At the age of 75, cycling, swimming and running. At the age of 75. So this fitness and take care of our health, I have learned from you sir, and I would like to mention you in the open forum. So that is why we started the yoga classes, when you told about fitness but nobody is coming and joining for the classes. Okay, so again, the next guru, what I say, our Executive Director Chandrasekhar Yadav sir, the man of simplicity, the man of iconic symbol of peace, and for everything, he has its own way of dealing the things very, very smoothly. This much of level of calmness, I have never seen the person who is holding such level of responsibility. This I have learned from our Executive Director, sir. So teachers means it is not like that who are all coming inside the classroom and taking the class and taking and giving you a lecture. There are some lectures on subjects, there are some lectures on life, there are some lectures about the philosophy, there are some lectures on profession. So you need to have a mentor in every phase of life. And there is an opportunity for you to learn from every individual. So these are all things which we can learn. Still I remember retired Colonel Ram Reddy sir, who is a positive source of inspiration to me. And all the time he was with me and he used to tell that, yes, you can do it. Yes, you can do it.